Is your smartphone making you dumb? I've asked myself this question lately as I constantly check how to spell words, Google historical events, and even look up simple directions.
Turn left.
I even use Facebook to remember my parents' birthday. And apparently I'm not alone. Studies show that using technology is affecting our ability to remember things. Instead of our brains storing information, frequent use of search engines like Google teach our brain to remember where we got the info from, leading to more web searches in the long run. Today, we'll explore how the abundance of tech is affecting our brain and what it could mean for the future of society.
The problem with talking about is our smartphone making us dumb, is it's really difficult to test, and it really boils it down as if there's like a binary. You're either smart or you're dumb, when in reality, you're intelligent with respect to different things. With respect to the kinds of intelligence that we might agree matter, do we have common sense? How do we relate to others? How do we socialize? Do I think they're affected by the technologies we use, by the smartphone? Sure.
Since the beginning of time, humans have always been innovators. Fire, the wheel, the internet. When we have a problem, we create new tools to solve it, making life way easier.
Now that I've gotten on the internet, I'd rather be on my computer than doing just about anything.
Take a spin, now you're in with the techno set. You're going surfing on the internet.
With the advent of the internet, information is more accessible than ever. Want to find the closest liquor store? Easy. Want to build a homemade rocket engine? Well, that might not be easy, but you get it. The information is out there. But there's a downside to this innovation. Researchers have discovered that technology is weakening our brain's ability to do things like recall information without the aid of a web search.
You might think, like, the GPS makes me smarter, right? I can now find my way all over the place. And in some sense, that's true, but again, who's smarter when you use the GPS? Who's engaged in route planning? Certainly, Google and Waze are gaining some intelligence, right? They know more about you, about where you are, about where you go, maybe of who you relate to. The question is, are you, in fact, smarter because you can use this device? Or when you outsource navigation and when you outsource sort of situational awareness of like your geography and the place you're in, how does that affect you over time, your own development, your own development of skills?
A four-year study by researchers at the University College London showed that when cab drivers memorize a network of 25,000 streets in London, they actually tended to grow more gray matter in the hippocampus. That's the area of the brain thought to be the center of long-term memory and the autonomic nervous system. But when those cab drivers retired or replaced their own navigational skills with a GPS, data show that the hippocampus actually started to shrink back to its regular size. Other research shows that young children exposed to more technology tend to show a decline in social skills. During a study with sixth graders, UCLA researchers correlated more screen time with less face-to-face interaction. In the long run, the lack of human connection led to decreased sensitivity to emotional cues and the inability to understand the emotions of other people. Here's a not-so-fun fact. Did you know that you remember less when you read from a screen? A study from the University of Stavanger showed that students that read physical text, like from a book, scored significantly higher in reading comprehension than those who read the same thing from a screen, like an iPad or a laptop. Another aspect of technology is it's constantly collecting huge amounts of our data. Every time you browse the web or open your favorite app, your data is collected and stored. Companies then use that data to help improve their customer service, execute more effective marketing campaigns, and even sell it to third parties. In Frischman's book, Reengineering Humanity, he warns of a future society where humans are indirectly programmed. The more data collected, the more sophisticated devices will become. This, he says, could cause humans to use their brains less, making them more susceptible of being manipulated when prompted by certain stimuli.
The envisioned future of the Internet of Things, where our homes are smart, our hospitals are smart, our streets are smart, that's a world that's increasingly programmed. We want to think about how it affects us as human beings when we're in those environments. I mean, do you want to be in a world in which everything is micromanaged on your behalf? What room does that leave for you to think and decide for yourself?
So does technology make us dumb? I guess that depends on what your definition of dumb is. But it's definitely changing the way our brains operate. We remember less, comprehend less, and are exposed to more stressors that change the way we socialize. Some experts advise we lower the time we spend looking at screens, as it can reduce many of these adverse effects. But as technology is integrated in almost every aspect of life, this might be easier said than done. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.